Welcome to the IFN Dhaba. We always have this reservation when we go out to eat street food that how healthy is it? But there's no need to go out. You have sufficient in your own kitchen and you can make the most popular and lip-smacking dish, and that is Pav Bhaji, which is loved all over the globe, especially Mumbai. So let's start making the Pav Bhaji. This is my version of it. So here I light the gas. And here I put in 2 sticks of butter. I don't wait for the butter to heat up because it can burn. So I'm just going to add garlic. This is about 3 tablespoons of finely diced garlic. So now I'll wait for the garlic to brown a little bit. These are about 3 to 4 green chilies which have been diced. Stirring it well. As you can see that the garlic has changed its color. It's become a little brownish. So we don't have to make it into a very dark brown color. Just a little change of color and it's good to go. So here I add in 1.5 onion, which is again finely diced. Now the onions will cook and we don't have to make them into a dark brown color. They have to be a little pinkish and more translucent. We add in 3 to 4 medium sized diced tomatoes. I mix it well. And I add in 1.5 teaspoon of salt. Salt you can put according to your taste, and keeping in mind that you've already added a lot of butter. I add in 1.5 teaspoon of chili powder. We've added green chilies as well as red chili powder, so it's pretty spicy. So if you don't want too much of spice, you can go easy on the spice. Now you can see that the tomatoes have become nice and pasty. So I will just remove a little bit of this masala. Which I'm going to be using it for the pav. Now I put in about 4 to 5 small tomatoes or medium size. They are nicely pureed. This dish is very tasty and very delectable because it's based basically on tomatoes and good amount of butter. Now I'll wait for the tomatoes to cook a little bit. So now you can see that the tomatoes have nicely cooked. And now I'm going to add in 4 to 5 medium-sized boiled potatoes, which have been just mashed. Now we added peas. This has been given just 1 spin in the mixer. You don't have to make them very into a fine paste. You just have to give it 1 spin and that's it. Just adding a little water. And then we use the masher to mash it. Now in pav bhaji itself, you can add cauliflower, you can add beans, choice of vegetables is totally yours, but my take on a pav bhaji is potatoes, onions, tomatoes, peas and a little of capsicum and lots of coriander and butter. Even the spices in this you can use as per your taste. Some people may not like it very spicy, some people like less of salt. So the salt and the chili powder and the green chilies is totally your take. So now we'll keep cooking this and keep mashing it. And I'll lower the flame as well so that it becomes nice, blendy and pasty. So now you can see that our bhaji is ready. It has to be this consistency, not very thin, not very thick. It's been mashed nicely. Now in goes one capsicum. You can add two also, finely diced. You have to add this towards the end so that crunch stays, because you don't need to cook it. Mixing it well. Then this is about 2 tablespoons of the pav bhaji masala. Stir it well. Then I will just add in a teaspoon of sugar. You can add in a teaspoon or tablespoon of tomato ketchup. This is just my tangy twist to it. And we just stir it, so it just cuts on the spice. So now the bhaji is ready, so I shut the gas. I add in 1.5 juice of lemon. Stir it. Add in lots of coriander, because this is what gives the actual flavor. Stir it well. And then we add a little more butter. So now we are ready with the bhaji. So we'll just do the pav quickly. So now we start doing the pav. The more liberally you use your butter, the tastier the pav is. Sprinkle some coriander. A pinch of red chili powder. We had kept some masala, so we just take a little bit. So this is your nice masala pav. You have 2 options. Either you can dice onions and keep raw onions with lemon aside, or you can make a masala pav like this and serve it. So here we have our most delectable pav bhaji, which is absolutely spiced up and ready to eat. If you like this recipe, subscribe to India Food Network. Till next time, goodbye.